And seeing that Rutgers University was known for its diversity, there's a lot of diversity in the population. But what I noticed, even just from the dining halls alone and spread out throughout the campus, was that a lot of students tended to hang out with each other. If you looked in the dining hall, I don't know if you guys know anything at your schools, if you notice that people of the same race hang out with each other. I mean, freshmen usually hang out together because they have nobody to hang out with, you know? The big group of 20, they're freshmen. But I remember looking around, and I remember there was like a whole section where all the black students and all the Asian students, and I'm a mutt, so I'm thinking, where the hell do I fit in? I mean, I'm a little bit of everything, so, you know, I mean, I can sit everywhere. But, you know, as far as the color of my skin, I was kind of looking around like, who do I sit with? And I remember I went over to the round tables, which they said were like where the black was at, and I was like, whatever, I like round tables, you know. And so I went over there and I sat at the round table and I'm like, there's my Shay. You know, a lot of people are ashamed that you find themselves in the cafeteria. I'm not, because I know that somebody hopefully will sit next to me. So I'm like sitting there and I'm like eating my food, and then this girl comes up and she's like, you ain't supposed to be sitting here. And I'm like, why? She's like, this is our table. I'm like, you know, try to be stupid looking at the table and be like, I don't see your name on it, you know? I'm like, but you can sit with me. And that was basically the first step for me stepping outside my comfort zone. It was kind of like, I mean, I like to push buttons in general, but, you know, I basically wanted to step outside my comfort zone and try to, like, meet people that I wouldn't normally want to meet and try to make friends with people, you know, that I wouldn't normally introduce myself to. Which brings me to my next question that I want to ask you guys. How many of you in the audience right now have prejudice? Raise your hands. No prejudice. All right, let me tell you why the rest of you guys are liars. If I were to put a picture up here of somebody that you didn't know, okay, just a random picture of somebody that was a perfect stranger to you, and I would ask each and every single one of you to write down what you think this person is like, every single one of you is gonna, based on looks alone, is gonna have something to say about what this person is like, based on your own experiences, based on what you saw on TV, based on what your parents tell you, based on like the movies that you see, or you know, people that you have met in your life. You're gonna be like, yeah, that person's like mean looking, or that person's like nerd looking, or maybe that person's really smart, maybe that person looks like smart. You know what I mean? You look at the thing and you go, oh, that person, you know, whatever, you know. You will definitely ask them to say, even if you don't know that person. That's what we call prejudice. It's prejudgment. Every time you look at somebody, in every single day of your lives, unless you're a hermit, you live in the forest, you don't talk to anybody but the birds, you know, every time you go and you see somebody, you will automatically, within 5 to 10 seconds, judge them. And in that 5 to 10 to 20 seconds that you're judging somebody, you're deciding unconsciously whether you even want to talk to this person. And it's based on your prejudice. Everybody has it, it's natural. You know, and we all, it's a natural thing. It's, you know, I'm like the computer, you know, I look at you and I'm like, yeah, I think this person, you know, I'm talking about. You know, saying, or like, oh yeah, maybe I think I get along with this person, looks nice. You know, and then you introduce yourselves, and that's what stepping outside your comfort zone is, because a lot of people have this thing called avoidance because of, you know, the way that people look. And I like to use the example of movie trailers. You guys know what movie trailers, right? You see on TV, you see this movie trailer, and you're like, oh, that movie looks awesome, I want to go see it. You see it, and you're like, totally sucks. And then, yeah, they always show the good parts on the trailers. You always see the movie, you're like, this sucks. And then there's this movie that you've all seen these trailers, but you never want to see the movie because of the trailer, because I know I have. And then one of your friends ends up renting the movie, and all of a sudden you watch it, and you're like, oh my God, this is such an awesome movie. But you would never know that by the trailer, because you automatically thought, because the trailer, that movie sucks, I don't even want to take a chance. Spend my $10, $15, how much is this movie nowadays? I guess it's max thing. I have a $2 movie in theater by my house, so I'm pretty lucky. But it's like a trailer, and that's what people are. That's what we as people are. Every time we're walking around, we are trailers. The way that we look, the way that we're dressed, you know, everybody looks at you and automatically they're watching the trailer to your movie. And the big problem is that people need to, you know, get to know the person. They need to see the movie. And a lot of people don't take that initial step, you know, to extend their hand and just take a chance on people. And that's one of the things that I had to learn in college in order to, you know, in order to be comfortable in my own setting, I didn't want to be segregated like everybody else. I didn't want to, you know, be like everybody else and hang out with people from my own race. I mean, come on now. I mean, I'm a mutt, so I mean, but then I'm brown, so I could fit in pretty much with anybody. And that's one of the lucky things about college, is that I could pretty much fit in with anybody. And no matter what group I was hanging out with, I mean, I had all kinds of friends, you know, and stuff like that. I've been called, you guys know what an Oreo is? And when I hung out with my white friends, a lot of people, I didn't even see my friends as white. After my initial culture shock, I started seeing people as people. But I did notice that whenever my Asian friends would invite me to a party, I noticed they were all Asian, and I'd be like, the only white people that were Asian, right? And I would always rag them about it, and then when I'd hang out like with my black friends, I'd be like, it's because I'm brown, right? And I'd look around like, what? Why is everybody black? You know? I mean, I'm going to call you out right now. I want to call you guys out. You invited me because I'm brown, right? And that's one of the things that is a huge thing that we need to really look at on our campuses is the way that people interact, the way that we introduce ourselves, the way that we don't step outside our comfort zones, and what we need to do is really get up.